That mid-century modern look is hotter than ever. But nowadays it comes with a whopping modern price tag.
I don't like that!
Design within reach?
Whose reach?
Dikembe Mutombo's?
That's where I come in. By restoring and upcycling furniture, I can get you that same look at a fraction of the cost. We get furniture everywhere. Thrift stores, estate sales, going out of business sales, the back of someone else's truck, pawn shops, a party you weren't invited to but wish you were, tag sales, dumpsters, your mom's house,
it's always big trash day somewhere,
abandoned high schools, pirate ships, side of the road. Yeah, we got a good one. By mixing unique pieces of furniture together, I'll make sure your space doesn't look like anybody else's. I'll take that one too. Actually, thank you. Okay, design team, wife, best friend, you guys are awesome.
So who are we helping this week?
I'm glad you asked. I actually wrote a song about it.
So crazy that you did.
Gordon, Gordon, Gordon family, that's their last name. And we're almost, almost, almost doing this for free because their budget is only $2,500.
I'm gonna remember that now.
These are their children, Birdie and Thurston.
Aw, they're cute.
Family of four. I'm Joey.
And I'm Ashley.
And we've been in this house for almost 7 years.
Hey. Joey, he's the contract plumber.
We reached a point where we really need to fix this place up.
Ashley, she's a stay-at-home mom.
Really, I feel like it's someone else's house, and I want it to feel like my house.
This used to be Joey's grandparents' house, and it still looks like it.
We have a lot of things that aren't ours.
Furniture that we inherited.
It's not really our taste.
I'm a little more modern. I like sleek lines.
We are ready for our own space.
There are three rooms in the house they want to renovate. The kitchen, formal living room, and a den.
Little dingy.
This room is kind of our biggest failure.
Ugly floral wallpaper. It's basically a time capsule.
This room is supposed to be the formal living space, but we've ended up using it as a kid's space.
That's too much. I can't eat that much.
So this is the kitchen. It feels really dark in here. This lamp is original. It's dusty. I'm sorry. I'm a bad housewife. We feel held hostage by other people's furniture.
I kind of feel like we're trapped in 1959. And I want to be living in 2021.
It's really dark. Really grandma.
It's got the curly trim. The wallpaper could just come off.
Get rid of that paneling or paint it white.
Throw it in the dumpster.
It just makes the space feel smaller and darker.
That's why we really need to focus on some furniture flips. If they've got anything in their house that we can, you know, get some skrill out of.
Skrilla for Rilla.
Hey, Clinton.
What's up, guys?
Hi, bud.
How you doing?
Yeah, you can too.
Oh.
So my first impression of the Gordon house was
dark vision activated.
Dark and dingy interior. Dated furniture and wall trim. Dated peeling wallpaper. Sofa blocking doorway.
Does not fit.
Does not compute.
What were they thinking?
Fan does not work. Also ugly. Really, really ugly. Play area clashes with formal furniture.
Tongue-colored sofa.
Non-edible, non-edible.
So my initial reaction is a little bit dated, a little bit dark. I see you've got a modern fridge here, but we are working with a 1959 counter depth. My thought is take that fridge, put it on the opposite side where you have more depth. We put a window here, letting the light in. We frame it with open shelving, and you still have plenty of room for storage. This is called millwork. Do you guys have any fine china?
Nope.
Neither does anyone anymore. All it does is end up collecting dust. You know, we've got like 3 inches here of dust.
Dust.
Oh, sorry.
See that? See that?
Yep.
Dust bunnies.
I name him Ted, the dust bunny. Let's rip that down. Let's add some optical height just by doing that.
Let's do it.
How do you guys feel about this dining room table?
It's gross. We didn't choose any of this stuff we inherited, like this table. It's been here for 60 years.
We like the poppy yellow.
I do too.
But it's just worn out.
We can keep something light and bright in here, but let's get something more modern, easier to maintain and clean.
Cool.
Perfect.
Let's take a look at the den. First thing I noticed was this pony wall. Do you guys use this?
It just collects toys and junk and random stuff.
Kind of breaks up the flow of the room. How would you feel if we just pulled the whole thing out of here?
Give me the sledgehammer.
Happy.
It's gonna make the space feel a little bit bigger and a little bit brighter and better, the three B's. How do you guys use this space?
Well, this is the adult living area.
We come in here to relax.
It's the one room in the house that's really dated.
The wallpaper is gross. The wainscoting is deteriorated. It's dingy.
We've got a sofa here that it doesn't fit your style. It doesn't fit the wall, literally, by that much.
That's my fault. I did
it. It's 5.75 inches. Maybe we take this sofa and bring it to the center of the room. It's going to make a great conversational area in front of the hearth of the home, where the TV also happens to be.
Absolutely. Sign me up.
What's this area over here?
It's a little schoolwork area for the children. We do homework, we do crafting.
So let me get this straight. They're doing homework and crafts at a table where their knees are kind of hitting this. We could get some raw knees going here. We can do better than this.
Yes, please and thank you.
This space looks really fun.
Well, it's supposed to be the formal living space, but we actually use it as a kid area. This bay window here, the children perform. So they'll recite little poems, play on their little guitars.
So this room feels like it's trying to do two things at once. We've still got pieces of a formal living room, but also have a musical playroom area. How do we feel about going all in on a musical playroom?
I love it.
Me too, love it.
All right, $2,500, not a lot of money. So to do this cost effectively, I'm gonna shop your house. Now here's what that means. I'm gonna be looking for furniture that I can upcycle and make useful for you, or furniture that I can flip for money to add to your budget.
Yeah, sounds good to us.
I just wish Cody was here to help me.
We've been here literally all day.
Oh, that's right, we carpooled.
All day.
Let's get started.
Okay.
All right, this piece right here, is it a coffee table?
More like console table. It looks like laminate. That's not good.
If you cut into this thing, you're just gonna have a bunch of sawdust inside.
Exactly. You can't really refinish it.
I don't know if it's usable. This is just not a super popular style right now. There's a hexagon table that matches it. $100.
Add it to the budget. Well, these things too.
What are these?
Oh, they were just little filing cabinets that my grandma had from the church.
Could we use them?
Yeah.
The kids need a desk, right?
Yeah.
So I'm thinking like wood slab, maybe live edge.
Mm-hmm.
We bolt these up underneath either side.
Seems kind of wasted since there's a pair of them. I'm thinking more of like two side tables encased in reclaimed lumber, hairpin legs. They wouldn't move like this. They'd sit flat.
Oh.
Yeah, they'd sit flat.
Side tables, we got it. Cheers.
Salute. This looks promising. Looks like hardwood.
So on the sides of these drawers, there's joinery. Sign of a well-made piece. Oh, that drawer is a little sticky. Might have to replace one of the drawer glides, but that's like under $10. Not only do I think we can flip this, I think we can upcycle it and really increase the value.
We could paint the hardware.
But we've got one little knob here.
So we can't,
so
do,
we
that.
Can't do that.
Yeah. Chrome.
Brass.
Brass. That's a good idea.
If we sand these back to natural.
Easy.
We paint the outer kind of shell. I think we're gonna get something stunning. Add it to the budget.
We transform the Gordon's dresser by painting it, sanding the drawer faces, and adding brass hardware. Now it has a great modern look that'll just grow on anybody. We listed it on Facebook Marketplace, and it sold for 200 dundies. Yay, now we can buy more stuff for the Gordon's rooms.
Okay, let's talk about this table. Are there leaves that go in it?
Yeah, I actually have two leaves that'll fit in there.
People don't really use leaves anymore.
So just by adding legs, we make coffee tables out of them. We sell the two coffee tables for $100 each. Sell this for like $300 as a set.
So $500 total.
Wow.
Added to the budget.
We'll need to take really good pictures of everything we're selling, which brings me to a really important topic.
How to stage.
Credenza.
It's boring.
It's brown.
It's blah. But proper staging will increase the perceived value.
And help it sell.
Rule number one.
Make sure your space is tidy and clean.
Staging rule number two.
Add objects to indicate scale.
Rule number three. Make sure there's plenty of light and lighting. Rule number four.
Plants.
Indicate a healthy environment.
If you take care of your plants, you probably take care of your furniture.
And yourself.
Rule number five.
Create contrast so your listing stands out. So follow those rules.
And use your dream imagination.
coming up on Clinton Tharp, Furniture Scientist.
I like that. Jack, what do you think? That means he approves when he waves.
You'll see like that typical time-lapse demo thing where we start renovating the house.
We're missing a brick here.
There's gotta be a brick around here somewhere.
Universe, show me something good!
Then you'll get to see us go shopping at like thrift stores and really weird places.
Does not smell like flowers. Dumpster.
Where we find cool stuff.
There's a couch right up here.
Oh my God.
Big dumpster. And then you'll see us transform it from like kind of, you know, just okay looking furniture.
That's a tulip table, Cody.
Into amazing stuff. And then,
all right, move it.
You'll see how it looks in the Gordons when we put it all together for the reveal.
All right, Gordons, come on in.
Oh my God. Wow. Oh, wow. Look at that fireplace. Fireplace really pops now.
It's so sophisticated in here.
Look at that.
Oh! It looks so amazing.
And the stadium seating. I love that seating.
I love that color.
That's my style. That is a beautiful fan.
What?
You guys nailed it. Oh, wow. Those look great.
Nice. See your pictures?
Yeah. Your picture's there. Do you like it? You guys about done yourself.
Make a big hug cuddle.
Oh.
Yay!
Big hug cuddle.
Thank you, everybody.
Gordon family.
It's comprised of
Joey, and Ashley. Almost.
Doing it for free. Oh, Gordon family.
So don't touch that dial, you goose. Stay tuned for more Clinton Tharp, Furniture Scientist. And pay attention to the ads, you know? You might want some of that stuff. You don't know.